The Halloween season is upon us once again, and the time has come to check in with everybody's favorite principal, sitting by the fire, telling scary stories.
And that is the story of how the dog turned into an ice cream cone.
Insane.
What's your scary story?
My scary story was on a night just like tonight, about 30 days ago, under that same moon.
Submitted for the approval of the Midnight Society, I call this story The Tale of the Husky. I decided to schedule a staff meeting at night, but the staff never came. I guess they didn't like to come to work at night. I was going to make s'mores and everything. I was sitting outside, waiting and waiting, wondering where everyone could be. Suddenly, I started to itch. I kept itching and itching. I couldn't stop. Why was I itching? Well, earlier that day, I was getting ready for school, and something caught my eye. Was the husky? Where did it come from? The itching was getting so bad. Before I knew it, I began to transform into the husky itself. I took off into the night, and by the next morning, I found my first prey.
I don't know what's going on, I just keep hearing things. This is weird. I have no clue. Whatever.
Whoa, what are you doing here? Hey, you got some good size to you. Hey, we need another guy on the basketball team. Let's see what you got.
More shocking than anything was how good I really was. I was the star of Huron Academy, and soon, the NBA. But through all my adventures, I learned there's a husky inside all of us. And that is the story of how I became a celebrity basketball player that was also a husky. Oh my gosh! Pause, what are you doing here? Oh, a Halloween scare in Michigan. That will be perfect for Stories with Subcheck. Well, kids, this is called A Halloween Scare in Michigan, written by Eric James. It's a perfect collection of all your spooky stories for this spooky holiday. I hope you have a lot of fun trick-or-treating. Be safe. Be sure to give some of the candy to your teachers, and we'll see you next time.
A Halloween Scare in Michigan, written by Eric James, illustrated by Marina LeRae. Prepare if you dare for a Michigan scare, a night of pure terror to whiten your hair. tale full of sights that are best left unseen. You ready? You sure? This was my Halloween. The werewolves howled loudly. The moon shone so bright. I stayed in my bedroom, the curtain shut tight. My heart started pounding. My knees felt so weak. But being a brave kid, I just had to peek. I pulled back the curtains. My mouth opened wide. An army of monsters had gathered outside. They staggered and stumbled and lurched down the streets with bags full of cookies and candy corn treats. Emerging from sewers and houses and stores came creatures and critters with ravenous roars. Then more came along from all over the state. They filled up the streets at a dizzying rate. From Lansing, Ann Arbor, and Kalamazoo, from Detroit, Grand Rapids, and Wyoming too, all gathered together for one spooky night to seek out the living and give them a fright. The thunder clapped loudly with terrible booms. The witches dodged lightning and clung to their brooms. The two-headed doggies tried chasing their tails, and banshees let loose with their hideous wails. The vampires hung out on the street in their gangs and grinned just to show off their pearly white fangs. The mummies moaned loudly and swayed side to side, while Frankenstein stomped about town with his bride. A big grumpy octopus strode into town. He picked up the locals and waved them around and said, "Please stop throwing my friends on the ice. You think that it's lucky, but no, it's not nice." A kraken awoke in a very bad mood, then rose to the surface to look for some food. She swam down the straits and attacked Mighty Mac. The upers and trolls had to beat the beast back. The creepies were crawly, the crazies were crazed. The zombies from Dearborn had eyes that were glazed. The ogres from the UP were ugly as sin, with big bulging noses and warts on their chin. The ghouls danced around but were lacking in soul. The gargoyles could rock and the headless could roll. Although the whole spectacle seemed to spell doom, I foolishly thought I'd be safe in my room. But then something happened that made my heart jump. From somewhere below me, I heard a big thump. I froze for a moment, as quiet as a mouse. Yes, I could hear noises from inside the house. I put on my slippers and pulled on my robe. I shook like a leaf, but I don't think it showed. Then slowly but surely, I crept down the stairs, preparing myself for the biggest of scares. My hands trembled wildly. I opened the door. I still shudder now at the horrors I saw. The stereo spat out some hideous sounds as dozens of monsters jumped madly around. The sight was horrific. It made my skin crawl. These monsters were having their Halloween ball. And right in the middle, one monster loomed tall, the hairiest, scariest monster of all. He turned round and saw me. I fell to my knees. "I'm not very tasty, so don't eat me, please." He beamed ear to ear and broke free from the huddle, ran over and gave me a big monster cuddle. "At last, we have found you," he said with a smile. "From Holland to Marquette, we've looked for a while. We came here to give you your wonderful prize." He held up a trophy in front of my eyes. "A prize, and for me?" I replied with a grin. "But what did I enter and how did I win?" "You've won the first prize for the costume you're wearing. It even scares me, and I'm tip-top at scaring." "This isn't a costume, I'm just dressed as me." "Exactly, the scariest thing you can be. A small human child with a cute button nose. Your teeth are so shiny, you've only 10 toes. No hair on your face and no horns on your head. The whites of your eyes are not glowing or red. A bone-chilling costume, a horrible sight. A worthy ensemble for Halloween night." We partied together until the moon set. A Halloween night that I'll never forget. And next year, I won't want to hide in my bed. The monsters won't scare me. I'll scare them instead. The end.